so early today, the Tour de France is ready to come into town. The city of Paris is waiting for the arrival of 135 survivors on this, one of the most interesting races for many, many years. The yellow jersey of Stephen Roche. He wasn't under attack all day. He just came onto the Champs-Élysées to confirm himself as the man who would win the Tour de France. Once the riders came into the city, they had to complete 6 4-mile laps up the Champs-Élysées and across the Place de la Concorde. Not surprisingly, everybody wanted to win today's stage. With only 4 miles to go, 9 riders started to break clear of the pack. And in front of them all was the American, Jeff Pierce, for the 7-Eleven team. 29 years old from Livonia, Michigan, Pierce has never won a stage in the Tour de France before. Ago, it was an American in Paris who won the Tour de France, Greg LeMond. Now at least there was a chance for the United States to go out on a high note and win the final stage. The main field behind dropped back to 10 seconds. Stephen Roche was only interested in winning the yellow jersey. Across the Place de la Concorde, Jeff Pierce glanced for the first time over his shoulder. He would see a gap of some 5 seconds for men chasing him home. Pierce swung into the home straight, just 200 yards to go. The pack behind it splintered, and all the way to the line, Pierce was chased by the Canadian Steve Barrett. The Tour de France is still making history. The first two riders to finish, Jeff Pierce from America, Steve Barrett from Canada. The first ever 1-2 for North America in the Tour de France. And 17 seconds later, the main field came home with Stephen Roche in the center of the pack, waving to the crowd. At last he'd done what he promised. He'd won the Tour de France. But this was also an historic day for the 7-Eleven team. They had had 3 stage wins, 2 of them by Americans in this Tour de France.
C'est fait, vous l'attendiez cette victoire.
Laisse pas tranquille, s'il te plaît.
And so Stephen Roche of Ireland wins the Tour de France, the time 115 hours, 27 minutes, 42 seconds, just 40 seconds in front of Delgado, with Andy Hamston finishing 16th, the last American, Jonathan Bowyer, 98th, almost 3 hours behind. And on the podium, pulling on the yellow jersey, Jacques Chirac, the French Prime Minister. While on our left, as we look at the picture, the Irish Prime Minister, Charles Hockey, the first time an Irish Prime Minister has come out of Ireland to welcome an Irishman on top of the world in a major event. So John Dockery caught up with Stephen Roche right after the finish.
Congratulations, Stephen Roche. You have the yellow jersey. 26 days, 2,500 miles. I mean, the torture out there. Can you tell me about it?
I think it would take too long to tell you everything about it, but it's really to know what it's like, or to imagine what it's like, you have to do it, or you have to know an awful lot about cycling, because you go from zero to 2,000 meters, back down to zero again, up into the mountains again. You go through good weather, bad weather, hail, rain and snow. You go through bad days, good days, sleepless nights, good nights. It's just a 3.5 week race with a bit of everything, and it's the survival of the strongest.
But Stephen, I'm a man who knows a little bit about pain. I saw you on top of the mountain collapse on your bike, yet you were able to recover. How do you do that?
I think it's something that, I think it's one quality I possibly have in myself. I'm very, very, I recover very, very quickly. And it's something which has always helped me in stage races all through my career. That's why possibly I perform better in stage races than I do in actually one day races, because I can recover very quickly. Like at the start of the tour, I was possibly tired than I am now, because after the Tour of Italy, I was very, very tired. It took me a while to recover. And now I'm even, wouldn't say I can do another Tour de France.
But now you, my friend, won only moments ago, won the Tour de France. You have the yellow jersey. Has it hit you yet, what it means?
Well, it actually hit me once when I was on the podium when they played the Irish National Anthem, because it's a long time since I heard it. And normally you only play it on big occasions. So I think it must be a big occasion.
This is definitely a big occasion. You are the first Irish winner ever.
Yes, but I think that's not really the feat of the purpose. The feat of the thing, I think, is to win the Tour de France. First Irishman or whatever, it doesn't mean a thing really. But to win a Tour de France is something big in itself.
What about next year? Some unfinished business. Greg LeMond wasn't here this year.
Greg, when Greg is there, it's one race. When I'm there, it's a different race. When Hino was there, it's a different race. And the race, the riders will make the race with ifs and buts. If Greg was here, if Greg wasn't here, you know, he can do a lot of things. This year, Greg wasn't here, and I won. Maybe Greg will be here next year. Maybe he still won't win. You never know. You just got to take the race as it is. There were 207 competitors, and I won. So that's all you got to look at.
Stephen Roche was here. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Hello, Greg.
And so the Champs-Élysées is being returned to the Parisians. As a newcomer to the tour, I've been flooded with impressions, but distilled to a few, they seem to fit the motto of France itself. Liberté, égalité, fraternité. The freedom these young athletes feel with a wind in their face in pursuit of the yellow jersey. The equality they show with their fans, hundreds of whom will don their club uniforms and climb the mountain stages, fantasizing that they are wearing the maillot jaune. And the brotherhood between teammates and competitors alike in those moments of agony and ecstasy. Yes, the Tour de France is France's pride and passion. Vive le Tour! For John Dockery, Phil Liggett, and the entire CBS production crew, I'm Tim Ryan. So long from Paris.
United can show you the old Hawaii where time takes a rest. And you can become yourself again. So come become Hawaii with the airline that's been her friend for nearly 40 years. United.
Monday.
I want to know what killed him and who supplied him.
A brilliant career that ended too soon.
Who are you protecting, kid?
Cagney and Lacey.
This is CBS.
That does it for today's adventure. If you're new here, please subscribe. Take it one step further, ring that notification bell. And if you enjoyed today's video, please give it a big old like and a thumbs up. It lets me know you care. I'll see you in the next video. Ride on.
Plus has a lubricating comfort strip to give you a smooth touch, an easy touch that's more comfortable than ever.
A touch that's easy makes me understand. When it comes to love, I want to slow it.
The new Chic Plus for the easy touch.
It was so simple. Really, a direct electrical charge here heats up the carbonized filament here, which in turn excites the gases trapped in here. And voila!
Well, it's very nice, Thomas. But I wanted a Bud Light.
If you want the great taste of Bud Light, ask for it.
Don't feel bad, Thomas. It's not a complete loss.
Bud Light. Because everything else is just a light.
Its wide, sweeping turns and high banks make it one of the world's fastest. The Talladega 500 on CBS Sports. Next.
This is CBS.